Hello Bookish Friends, welcome to my March TBR. In this video, I will first of all talk about the books that I plan to read in the month of March. And in the second part of the video, I will talk about the books that I plan to read for my reading challenges and the readathons that I will participate in the month of March, which are March Mystery Madness, Middle Grade March, as well as Fierce Reads. In the month of March, I plan to read three books. The first one is the next book in the series that I'm reading with Amy and Zobek, which is The Secret Life of a Vampire by Carolyn Sparks. This is the sixth book in Love at Stake series, and so far the books in those series have been very fun to read, and I'm hoping it will be the same for this one. The second book is also a next book in the series, which is Sam Wyndham series by Abir Mukherjee. And I'm reading this series with Naomi and Nikki. The second book in the series is A Necessary Evil by Abir Mukherjee, as I mentioned before. And the last book that I plan to read is a book that we couldn't read in the month of February. I think it worked out for the best, since I can use it for middle grade March. I plan to read Under the Whispering Door by T.J. Klune with Laurie at Books Ink and Paper. It has been so long since we read a book together, and I am very, very excited that we will have a chance to read this middle grade book. For my book clubs, I plan to read three books again. The first one is the book club book that I will read for my besties book club. And this book club consists of my three best friends from the university. We will read a Turkish mystery book together, which is Kayıp Tanrılar Ülkesi by Ahmet Ümit. Other two books belong to my online book clubs. First one is Bridge to Terabithia by Catherine Patterson. I will read this book for FOMO book club, Fear of Missing Out book club, co-hosted by Gemma, Alice and Jack. Last book is the book that I will read for Nancy Drew Read Along, which is The Secret of the Red Gate Farm by Caroline Keane. Could not participate in the group as much as I wanted in the previous 2 months. But this month, I am determined to be more active in the chat group hosted by Mitzi. For my Books of Alfred Hitchcock project, this month's book is Vertigo, which is originally published in 1954 under the title D'Entre les Morts by French author team Pierre Beloy and Thomas Nargerac. This book was adapted into a very famous Alfred Hitchcock movie in 1958. Since I really, really did like the movie, I cannot wait to read this book. TBR Reads Cup is the cup that I put all of the books from the previous TBRs that I could not finish. For the month of January, I read all of the books that I mentioned in my TBR. So I will not put any extra book to the cup this month. The book that I will read for March will be Verity by Colin Hoover. I have read contemporary romance novels by this author. To be honest, I was not very impressed. But I've heard that this thriller book is much more different. And many of the friends that I trust their taste has liked this book very, very much. I guess it's time for me to try this book by Colin Hoover. For Read Your Shelf Challenge, created by Chantal at Chantal Reads All Day, the prompt for March in the Sherlock Holmes path was to read a book with more than 2 points of view. And for this one, I chose a thriller, which I could use for March Mystery Madness as well. which is The Guest List by Lucy Foley. This book is marketed as one of the modern retellings of And Then There Were None, my favorite Agatha Christie book. And I have liked what I read from Lucy Foley so far. So I think this will be a good addition to the Agatha Christie retellings that I've read. The first periodathon that I plan to participate is March Mystery Madness. Elizabeth at Lizzie Fay Loves Books is one of the co-creators of this readathon, and I've participated to this readathon for I think 7 years, even before I started the channel. This year, although there are 9 prompts, which all sounds awesome, I've decided not to do any of the prompts except one, which is Janelle prompt, to read a book that reminds me of Janelle. And A Necessary Evil by Abir Mukherjee, it was a series that was recommended by Janelle to me. And during our buddy read of this series with Nikki and Naomi, we talk about Janelle a lot. I can clearly see why she would like this series so much, since she was a big fan of historical mysteries. And there are plenty of books on my TBR that I could read for this readathon, which are The Hollow by Agatha Christie, Kayıp Tanrılar Ülkesi by Ahmet Ümit, The Secret of the Red Gate Farm by Caroline Keane, The Guest List by Lucy Foley, Verity by Colin Hoover, and also Vertigo by Pierre Boulez and Thomas Narkajak. So I'm guessing March will be a month full of mystery for me. But I will also participate in Middle Grade March, like I mentioned before. And like March Mystery Madness, I will not do any of the prompts. I will read 3 books for this readathon, which are Bridge to Terabithia by Catherine Patterson, The Secret of the Red Gate Farm by Caroline Keane, and Under the Whispering Door by T.J. Klune. The last readathon that I'm planning to participate is Fierce Read, which is a readathon in celebration of International Women's Day. And this readathon will take place in the month of March. I will link some of the announcement videos down below. For this one, there are actually 6 prompts, but I will do only 2 of them. For the prompt of picking a book by a fierce female author, I will read The Hollow by Agatha Christie. And for the prompt of choosing a book with a strong female protagonist, I will read The Secret of the Red Gate Farm by Caroline Keane. So those are the books that I plan to read for the month of March. I'm glad that I could use the same books for many of the challenges and the prompts. So please comment down below, have you read any of the books that I mentioned in this video? And what did you think of them? And if you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye. For Turkish word of the day, I'm going to choose guest. Guest means konuk in Turkish, and konuk is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day.